G'day guys, back again. Hope you're all doing well. I've been thinking about doing this video for a while. This video is pretty much going to be about building a good base for your model. It's going to be about picking the right base, how to save money with your base, and also just protecting your model in general. This will probably be most likely a two-part video, just because it's going to be reasonably in depth, and hopefully it'll save some people some money, and also maybe improve their placings in competitions, or just when they're showing it to friends and family, or improving their price of their commissions that they might charge on their building kits for people. As you can see here, I pulled out a couple of my models that I've done, and I just wanted to show you the variation in bases and probably some of the do's and don'ts that I think when building a base that I've learnt over my time and that I've obviously seen in competitions, and I just thought I'd share that with you guys. Hopefully you enjoy it, and hopefully it'll improve your modelling experience. Very quickly, I'll just touch on this as I've touched on it on some of my other videos, so I won't go into it too much, but as you can see on this base here, there's a lot of dust on this base. I've done this model quite some time ago, and I actually didn't put a casing over the top of it, so it doesn't take very long to get a model dusty. The issue is that sometimes you can get the dust off the bases sometimes, but sometimes if you've got a base like this and you've got snow in it and grass, it gets pretty tricky to try and get a lot of dust out of that. It's not an easy task, especially if the snow isn't glued in. You can't vacuum that up or anything like that, because it's just going to take the snow with it. So it's one of the issues of not putting a case over the top of your models. As you can see here, I've got some cases over the top of these ones. Obviously, if you're going to spend a lot of time making a model, building it, painting it, I don't understand why you wouldn't put a top over it just to keep the dust off it. Obviously, if your intention is just to throw it out after you finish building it, that's fine. But if you can afford it, I think buying an acrylic case or a cheap, even a Tupperware container is the way to go. This one here is probably about $15, $20 that cost me, probably cheaper in other places. This is a pasta jar. This probably cost me, I think, around $7 or $8. Sometimes people might go, I don't even want to spend $8 on trying to protect my model. I just want to actually use that money to buy another model or paints or something. So the next step is you get plastic bags from your shopping center when you buy something. This is the cheapest option. Just whack that over the top of your model and let it sit there. It costs you nothing and it protects your model from dust. Very cheap, very simple. That way when your friends come over or people come over, you can pull it out, rip this off in about 30 seconds, and then you've got your reasonably dust-free model. This plastic bag, in my opinion, sitting this over the top, maybe wrapping it underneath the base, is going to protect your model from dust a lot better than a lot of those IKEA cabinets. They still get a lot of dust in those IKEA cabinets. So sometimes I actually put my model in the IKEA cabinet and display, and sometimes I'll just whack a plastic bag even inside it over the top of the model. That way, when you come to show someone, you can pretty much pull it off. And I've had this displaying outside for a while, but as you can see, there's a lot less dust on this base compared to the other base I just showed you. So for the price of no money to maybe $15 or $20, if you really want to show your model around or put it in a contest, maybe in 6 months time or a year's time or something, make sure you put an acrylic case over it or a plastic bag. As I said, I'm gonna do a reasonable in-depth video or two on bases here. So I'll just give you a quick zip around of some of these bases and showing you the varying types and the problems that I think has occurred with some of these bases, and also just some of the tips that I might be able to share with you guys. So I'll just give you a quick zip around. Okay guys, I'm just going to start off with a general talk about the actual base itself, buying a base for your particular model.